sinking land in the San Joaquin Valley. A new NASA study now says we're losing 2 feet a year.
We should be worried. I mean, it is a concern.
So we've heard of it before. It's called subsidence, and it's a problem all across Northern California made worse by the drought.
But now that we've had more rain, has the land stopped sinking? CBS 13's meteorologist Lisa Meadows is live in Davis getting answers.
That's right. We're out here in Davis. Now, this is one of the locations that's mentioned in that new study with minor subsidence, and that just hints to the collapsing of that aquifer. Now, it turns out this is not the only location in the Sacramento Valley.
We should be worried. I mean, it is a concern. It's expensive. It's impacting farming activities. It's impacting the delivery of water.
The concern is subsidence, a situation that has been around for a long time but didn't become a problem until a couple of years ago when we were deep into the drought.
What's causing it is groundwater levels are lowering.
As California endured years of drought, the lack of surface water led to more groundwater pumping from below ground aquifers. And that lowered groundwater levels. Eventually, the land in the San Joaquin Valley started to compress and sink.
Anything that crosses these areas of subsidence, roads, railways, pipelines, anything like that is impacted and is damaged by subsidence.
We started seeing the damage a couple of years ago, so the Department of Water Resources asked NASA to collect and analyze new data during the last 2 years. The department released its findings earlier this week, and the results are not good. The areas in the San Joaquin Valley that had been subsiding have continued to drop as much as 2 feet per year. Not only that, but small amounts of land subsidence were also identified in the Sacramento Valley near Davis and Arbuckle and north of Lake Tahoe, the first time ever in the Sierra Valley. There was a slight improvement during the winter of 2015-2016 when subsidence slowed down. That's because rainfall met crop water needs. But NASA says even with more rain, we've had such a groundwater deficit for so long, it will take some time before we can refill those underground reservoirs and the aquifers that have completely collapsed. That means that storage capacity is likely lost for good.
Now, NASA is actually teaming up with the Indian Space Research Organization. They're putting together a radar study to continue to look at subsiding land across California and also across the world. Back to you. Some pretty fascinating stuff. All right. Thanks so much, meteorologist Lisa Meadows.